I've just recovered from the archive some of the sounds encoded in that disc.
Adanesh Lushulmu.
Hartelijke groeten aan iedereen.
Herzliche Grüße an alle.
Tahiyyatuna lil astiqa fi nujum.
I think we just heard greetings in Akkadian, Dutch, German, Arabic. There is also a selection of music, sounds, images from Earth. Instructions in symbolic language to explain the origin of the probe and how to play the record.
We're about to reach the wormhole entry point. We need to jump in 5 minutes. We've slowed down. Still a few minutes before engaging the wormhole.
A wormhole is a shortcut between two distant points in the universe. It's a bit like traveling from Liverpool to Sydney through the Earth's interior instead of flying around the globe. A wormhole has two entrances called mouths. They are connected to each other by a tunnel through hyperspace that can be just a few kilometers long.
We're heading towards one mouth of the approaching wormhole. The other end is situated about 50 light years away, around the star Taubutis. At this speed, we will traverse the wormhole in a couple of seconds.
Wormholes can be constructed following standard laws of physics, but we are unable to create a stable wormhole in practice.
These are the mouths of several wormholes scattered throughout the Milky Way. We know of their existence thanks to the Santorio anomaly, a signal detected more than 10 years ago by the Santorio satellite. The signal lasted only 5 hours, but it's taken us several years to decode what seems to be a map of shortcuts throughout the galaxy and beyond.
The signal appeared to be coming from the other side of this wormhole. We think that its source is around the star Taubutis. Whoever sent this message may also be responsible for creating this net of wormholes.
30 seconds to crossing.
We have been orbiting the star Taubutis B for several days, searching for answers about the origin of the Santorio anomaly. There is a giant gas planet like Jupiter orbiting this star. It's called Taubutis B and was one of the first extrasolar planets to be discovered during the last decade of the 20th century. Checking the historical records, I found that in 2003, Chris Lee, a scientist from John Moores University, led a study of the starlight reflected by the planet.
Taubutis is a star which is not very different from the Sun. Its mass is 40% larger, its radius is 50% larger, and the surface temperature is about 6,000 degrees Celsius, which is about 500 degrees hotter than the Sun itself. Now, Taubutis B is a giant gas planet, probably about 6 to 7 times the mass of Jupiter, and it moves around in a very, very close orbit to its parent star. With an orbital period of just around 3 days. That would mean that the length of the year on this planet would be only 3 days. It's thought that the star is heating the planet to around 1500 degrees centigrade, and that the stellar winds from the star are slowly blowing parts of the planet off into space. Taubutis B was discovered back in 1996 by studying the motion of the parent star.
We have completed our study of Taubutis, its giant planet, and its satellites. We did not find any sign of intelligent activity in this system. We are now close to the companion star of Taubutis, a red dwarf with mass about 20% of the solar mass, half the solar radius, orbiting the more massive neighbor in 2000 years at a distance of 30 billion kilometers.
There's a planet like Mars, so close to its star that it's become tidally locked. It takes about 20 days to rotate around its axis, as well as to orbit around the star. Therefore, one hemisphere is always facing the star, the same way that the Moon does with the Earth. As a consequence, one side of the planet is in perpetual daylight and the other in eternal night. This creates large temperature variations between the two sides, mitigated by the heat transferred from the day side to the night side by the planet's atmosphere.
I'm now going to travel to the planet and will show you some detail of its surface. Dave, tell Mike I'm going down to the surface for a short broadcast. On my way to the planet, I'm going to land in the twilight zone between day side and night side. The approach route is programmed. Dave, any news?
Again, no sign of intelligent activity. Not yet.
Maybe it was a transmitter of some sort, programmed to send us just one message.
No detection of artificial bodies in the system. We'll keep scanning.
Maurizio, you have half an hour on the surface for the public globe.
Okay, Helen. I won't stay a minute longer. Scanning for a landing site. Scanning the surface. Studying landing procedures.